24-year-old white male suspect. His name is James Holmes, H-O-L-M-E-S.
And now that we have his name, we can go ahead and do some more research on him for you and get a little bit more about his background, hopefully, as we can log onto our courts and our databases and find out if he has any previous history with law enforcement, perhaps if he is a resident of Colorado or has come from somewhere else. And so we'll be working on that right now. And as soon as we get more information on the 24-year-old suspect, James Holmes, we will pass that along to you right now. All we know about him is that he lives in an apartment believed to be in North Aurora, where the SWAT team is now combing and trying to gather evidence that he came to this movie theater, the Century 16 Theater in Aurora, last night around midnight when the Batman movie, the premiere of The Dark Knight Rises, started, and around 12:30 he opened fire inside one of those theaters, theater number 9, and he went to the front of the theater. According to witnesses, they saw a flash, they heard a hissing sound, smoke filled the air, and then multiple shots rang out, striking at least 50 people we now know are among the injured. 12 people are confirmed dead. Those 50 people who are injured taken to area hospitals, many of the hospitals bringing in all of their staff to be prepared for all the trauma that would be coming in not long after. Aurora police made the arrest in the parking lot of this theater, which is now cordoned off to any traffic. All those cars you see there were there for the movie or were at the theater at the time this shooting happened, and they are on scene right now gathering as much evidence as possible, trying to learn more about the motive of 24-year-old James Holmes, as well as whether or not there are potentially any other threats out there.
Yeah, and so far they just had this one gunman, and they don't think it's any other tie to any kind of terrorism or other suspect. But at this hour, you know, it's still early on. We've been on the air since about 3 this morning, so it's only a few hours into this. Aurora police tell us the shooting started at about 12:30. There was that midnight showing, again, of the Batman premiere. So you can imagine, with all the hype about that movie, those theaters were packed. And so as you look at that building there from Air Tracker 7, that's the one that sits across the parking lot from the Aurora Mall. And there were at least two theaters that were showing the movie. Theater 9, where the gunman was, and then there was Theater 8, the one next to it, that had the bullets and shrapnel go through the wall. Again, there was some kind of explosive device that started off the whole incident. It seemed to be a smoke grenade, a smoke canister, or multiple of those. It made it tough to see if it wasn't already tough to see in a dark movie theater. And then those shots started.
And what's really scary is this caught everybody by surprise. Nobody saw it coming. They thought it was fireworks. Most of the witnesses we've talked to in both theaters thought they were hearing fireworks, perhaps a prank by one of a teenager or somebody who was in the theater. Those theaters packed with young adults, teenagers, even families who brought some young children, and we've heard the youngest victim, not knowing the specific injuries, but we do know a 3-month-old was injured in this shooting, according to the University of Hospital spokesperson there. And our Marshall Zellinger is on scene near where the gunman lives.
Yeah, he's over there near that 17th and Oswego area where they've been swarming around that apartment complex. Marshall, what are you seeing at this hour?
Well, it's interesting. Behind us here, you see another fire truck has arrived on the scene. They got here shortly after the last time we were live, and they have hooked up, or they're in the process of hooking up one of the hoses to the fire hydrant just on the corner here at 17th and Oswego. From where we are, just about a half a block to 3/4 of a block down and to the right is the apartment complex that is being searched, where we believe that police believe James Holmes, the suspect in this theater shooting, lived. A number of armored vehicles are here just beyond the fire truck in the center of the road. I'm going to step behind my photographer to peek to the left here. And there is, that is the newest armored vehicle, or at least heavy police vehicle I've seen arrive. We also saw Adams County Sheriff as well here. And I know that you guys were talking the footage from Air Tracker earlier of someone in SWAT gear using some sort of device to look inside the apartment complex. And we heard from residents who were evacuated about an hour and a half ago that before that was going on, the police that first arrived on scene around 1:32 in the morning, they were going into the apartments, busting windows and going in, knocking on doors. And then it seems they have pulled back since then and taken more of a precautionary approach. Down here at ground level, we're trying to stay, I know we're cheating a little bit beyond this middle line of 17th Avenue, but we're told not to go on that side of the street, but that is a danger area. The safe area is over here, and I can only guess that's because the apartment that they're searching, if there were explosives inside, probably whatever might explode would go toward the far north side of the street. But that's every time we creep closer this way, we're reminded by the officers behind us that we're in a safe zone where we are right now.
Yeah, so they're still trying to get a sense of what may be inside that apartment or like the whole complex. And so how far do those evacuations go? Does it go beyond that, just that one building? Is it several blocks?
I tried to make a quick walk of the perimeter, and actually I can see the police tape has been stopped about 2-3 homes up Oswego between 17th and 18th. You can see the police tape behind me. Beyond that fire truck is going to be Parrish Street, and then the stoplight after that is Peoria, and I believe that the police tape goes all the way to Peoria. And on this south side is another one or two homes in this direction. So I'm going to guess you've got the apartment complex and just a handful of homes, but on that far corner of the intersection where we met Rebecca and Leanne a little earlier, you can see there's a good dozen and a half people standing on that far corner at Oakland and 17th, and that's where they were told to evacuate too. They've just been hanging on that side of the intersection for a while.
And we're monitoring our Air Tracker 7 video right now. You can see a ladder has been extended from a vehicle in the parking lot to one of the apartment windows. It's unclear what specifically they're trying to accomplish. At other times, we have seen SWAT members standing on top of rooftops, standing on top of vehicles. So it appears that it's an upper apartment where they are trying to search and gather evidence and information. It's unclear what they're going to find, but the suspect in custody, 24-year-old James Holmes, did tell police at some point in time that made them believe at least there was a potential to have explosives in that apartment as well as in his vehicle.
Yeah, they hopefully using that ladder to try to get a little better look inside.
I'm going to go make a move.
And Marshall's still on scene trying to gather some information, talking to many people who lived in that apartment complex. It's been tough finding someone who knows the suspect, which again we've now confirmed is 24-year-old James Holmes is his name. The suspect in this case, who went into this theater a little after 12, about 20 minutes into the movie Batman Dark Knight Rises at that Century 16 Aurora Theater complex, not far from this apartment complex where they believe he lived, threw one or several smoke grenades in Theater 9, began shooting so much firepower that they went through some walls into Theater 8. So you have people who were injured and killed in Theater 9 and in Theater 8, we believe, as well. But there were police recently, within the last 30 minutes, they've updated. They got a better handle on the situation. It's a very frantic scene. They originally said 14 dead. They're saying now 12 dead. So that has come down a bit. That is a bit of good news. We're still on about 50 people injured.
And unfortunately, they range in all ages, all walks of life. We know as young as a baby to people in their 30s, to teenagers who are among those who were affected by the shooting. And we now know there are police from all over the metro area, law enforcement agencies from across the country who are helping in this investigation this morning. As far as those local agencies involved, we can confirm Jefferson County's there, Arapahoe County, the Aurora Police Department, Boulder Police Department's been called in, the FBI is also on scene right now, and many of them bringing in their bomb squads and their SWAT teams because this is such an intense situation and such a huge crime scene. And now we have two scenes that they're having to process, both the apartment complex and that Aurora Theater. We know that people are standing by, blocking the entrances, we've been told by our reporters out in the field, that Arapahoe County has guns in hand as they are blocking those entrances, making sure nobody comes in and out, as they make sure that there aren't anybody else, there's nobody else out there who could want to cause any harm. They do just believe it's this one person who was involved, the 24-year-old suspect in custody, James Holmes.
One of the interesting things, if not comforting, is when this when they first got the call from Aurora Police at 12:30, they put a bulletin out of sorts that alerts all the jurisdictions around them for multiple reasons. Not only to kind of zero in and bring this thing to a quick end, but also early on, they didn't know exactly what they had on their hands. There was some fear that maybe this might happen at some other theaters. You can imagine the number of theaters around town showing that midnight, much anticipated movie, again, Batman Dark Knight Rises. So they didn't know if they might have something going on at other places. That did not turn out to be the case. But nonetheless, these multiple agencies, multiple hospitals from various places across the metro area, all